Here comes that one question that everyone asks, sooner or later. Is BDS easy? Sure, BDS is easy. If you think crying over a like wax block at 2 a.m. is easy. If you think wearing plaster all over your scrubs like a modern art is easy. If you think carving mountains instead of teeth is easy, then yeah, here comes your answer. BDS is very easy. But if you are even thinking of taking dentistry, let me walk you through the mess that no one wants you about and why, despite it all, we stay. So let's start with year one, the year of crushed dreams and crushed wax blocks. So you walk into your lab all excited. They hand you this tiny cuboid or wax that comes in different shades. And they say, student, carve a tooth out of this. I swear, I laughed like, carve a tooth out of this? You mean to tell me I am going to sculpture a tooth? Like I am some sculpture artist. Then 2 hours later, my wax block looked like, I don't know what to say, and that fell on the floor and got stepped on. And the instructor just said next. I went home that day questioning my entire career choices. And that was just day one. So then comes the day they tell you make a cast. Oh, you think it's funny? No, it's a curse. You mix this white plaster powder in water thinking it's going to behave, and then it explodes all over your hands, your scrubs, your bench. That day I went home with plaster in my hair, in my scrubs, even my shoes, and thought, why didn't anyone tell me this is what first year actually is? And I mean, nobody knows that happens in first year. And to this point also, we are still covered with POP all over our scrubs. So yeah, it never ends. And just when you think you have figured things out, second year hits. I know this is like when you bring out the phantom heads. Basically, a creepy mannequin with a mouth that you practice on. Sounds cool, right? But until you sit down and realize you are supposed to carve perfect cavities in actual extracted teeth. Also in like fake teeth, which I'm gonna tell you afterwards. But yeah, in extracted teeth, you heard me right. So we do with an instrument called a micromotor. Oh, and let me tell you about the micromotor. It's basically so slow, painfully slow. You have to push so hard just to drill even a millimeter. And don't even ask about air rooters. We are not trusted with those yet. Too fast, too dangerous. So yeah, just sit there, arm aching, trying to shape a tooth while your neighbor's prep already looks like a textbook diagram. And you look like, wow. And just when you think you're finally getting the hands over wax, plaster, and in second year, making cavities on the phantom heads, they hit you with the rear horror. That's exams. See, theory is one thing, but in dentistry, you don't just write about it. Oh no, you have to perform it in front of a teacher who is staring into your soul the whole time while you try to pretend your tooth does not look like a creepy thing. Then comes the viva. Oh god, the viva. Viva se to sabko hi dar lagta hai. Although viva is very famous kyunki tumhe bas teen cheez aati hai. Sorry. But yeah, anyways, but you know what happens? You could have studied all night, read the textbook 3 times, practiced all the questions. But the moment they say your name, your brain turns into that plaster powder and flies away. So yeah, exams in dental college are different level of stress. But hey, at least viva ke horror se kuch interesting stories to mili jati hain. So like about later with your friends, you can laugh ki viva mein kya experience hai. But haan, initially bahut horror hota hai. And just when you thought dental was all about hands-on stuff, let me introduce you to the real monster. That's theory. Dental has more like theory than anyone wants you about. We initially think ki hame to bas bhai tooth carve karne hain, cast banani hai, etc. But nahi guys, we need to study a lot. We have subjects like dental materials, oral histology, anatomy, physiology, microbiology, and all those endless mug up points that somehow never stay in your head when you need to know them the most. And then you walk into the theory exam thinking you are ready, but somehow the paper looks like it's written with such a disgusting language. You sit there trying to understand and remember what you like studied, but boom, everything explodes at that moment. Look, half the time you are just writing prayers between the lines, hoping that you pass, but don't even get started on diagrams. You think you are an artist until they ask for a perfect cross-section of a tooth. Or a cross-section tak bhi sahi hai, but with H&E pencil. It's type of like stain pencil, jisse you need to make cells, nuclei. Ek dot, ek diagram mein bhi 50-50 dots hote hain. That's like hundreds of diagrams you need to draw into your like exams. So you need to poke into your answer sheet again and again to make the nuclei. But you know what? Somehow we survive. One chapter, one answer, one bad diagram at a time. And you start realizing you are learning more than you ever thought you could. And that's the best part. And you know what? Somehow you survive. If you are someone watching this because you are about to start your own BDS journey, here's something I do want to tell you. The kind of college you choose can make a huge difference to how your experience turns out. You need the right environment, faculty, support, clinical exposure, and resources to really build your confidence as a future dentist. And I'm getting so many comments on my videos that after they have given their NEET, like which is the best affordable college in like UP. I'm getting so many comments. So one college I definitely recommend looking into is Dental College Azamgarh, one of the best prestigious dental institutions in Uttar Pradesh with over 20 years of excellence in dental education. Recognized by Dental Council of India, affiliated to Atal Bihari Vajpayee Medical University, and really stands out because of its advanced clinical exposure, modern labs, high experienced faculty. Their on-campus hospital sees a high patient inflow, which means you get real hands-on practice from the start. And as I said, the best part is it's affordable while still giving you quality education and a supportive student-friendly campus environment. So if you are NEET qualified and looking for a good dental college, it's a good place to start your journey. Check them out. I've left all the details in the description below. Alright, now let's talk about the good parts of dental college. The fest, the friends, and those little moments that keep you going. But you know what keeps you going? The good parts. And yes, they are good parts. You find your lab partners. You laugh over your horror preps. You borrow each other's instrument. You stay late practicing together, eating samosa in between. Yeah, it really happens. Beech-beech mein samosa, like drinks, chalti hai. Not that drinks. You make friends, you'll never forget. And then one day you are standing in the clinic watching your seniors treat real patients, and something inside whispers like, one day that's going to be me. One day I am going to be a dentist. Yeah, it really happens. Every time I personally, when I see like my seniors, I like, wow, I am gonna treat actual real patients. So, to anyone watching this, if you are a NEET aspirant or even a scared first year fresher, here's what you need to know. It's not easy. It's not glamorous. It's not what Instagrams make it look like. It's messy. It's hard. It's exhausting. But it's really beautiful in its own chaotic way. And one day, when you finally see a patient smile because of you, you realize why you chose this path. So stop worrying about what others say. You are not less. You are not a backup. You are not making a mistake. You are building smiles, and that's what counts. So, and yeah, it's worth everything. And the next time someone says like, or ask, is BDS easy? Just smile back and say no, but it's worth it. Trust me guys, it's worth it. It's coming from a dental student, so believe me. If you laughed, cried, or felt called out watching this, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this with someone who thinks dentistry is easy. And comment below your most hilarious or relatable BDS moment. Let's laugh at this chaos together. And yeah, don't forget to brush your teeth and stay blushed.